Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة. Obviously, Jannah is the greatest. When I say something greater, I'm talking of immediate. There can be nothing that we will achieve greater than Jannah in the hereafter. But in the dunya, for us to achieve a good life, that is what Allah says. Whoever believes, from male or female, and does good deeds, meaning is steadfast on the path, we will make their life a happy one to start with. Notice the terms. A pure life, a good life, a happy life. Allah didn't say, we will give them what they want. Many of us misunderstand, and we think if Allah is happy with us, He gives us what we want, and if we don't have what we want, that means Allah is upset with us. Sometimes because He loves you so much, He did not give you something. Sometimes because He loves you so much, He inflicted you with some form of calamity. Nobody ever promised that in this world we would get whatever we wanted, because if that was the case, what was the point of having a paradise a little bit later? When I have everything I want here, we'd want to live forever and ever. We still want to live forever and ever, even though we don't have whatever we want. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you want contentment. You want happiness. You want to lead a good life, happy life. Well, we have the solution. Be steadfast on the path. We give it to you here to start with in terms of contentment. Like I told you, and I've just given you a small example, roof leaking, you won't get angry. It's a sign of contentment. May Allah grant us contentment, not only the roof. Roof is minor, but when major issues occur in our life and we say, Ya Allah, do not test us with tests that will be very difficult for us to pass. There are certain things that happen in our lives that are major, major. Believe me, those who go through that type of a test, Allah loves you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا أَحَبَّ عَبْدًا ابْتَلَاهُ. When Allah loves you much, He makes you go through many more tests. Those from amongst you who have lost children in infancy, who have given birth stillborn, those from amongst you who have lost children, believe me, it's a sign of the love of Allah. He's giving you an opportunity to get so close to Him. Embrace that opportunity. Embrace it. It may never come again. That is your paradise. That is it. Those who are terminally ill, that's your paradise. Those who are going through heavy turbulence, that is your paradise. Be steadfast. Don't lose hope. Don't sway. Shaitan might come and make you lose hope. Never. That is your paradise. Paradise does not come cheap. It comes with a payment. And that payment, subhanallah, for some might be a little bit easier than for others. But look at what we said yesterday. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went through so much. He lost children. He lost his sons. Allahu Akbar. He lost them one after the other. All of them. He didn't have parents. He had no father when he was born. Some time later he lost his mom. He lost his grandfather. A while later he lost his uncle. Look at that. One after the other. So if you think Allah does not love you because you have lost a child, or you've lost a spouse, or a parent, or a loved one, you're actually totally wrong. Those whom He loves with guaranteed love, much more than myself and yourselves, He has tested them with much more. They were steadfast. In another verse in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the beauty of steadfastness. He says,
إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم.
Those who have said,
that our Rabb is Allah, and they have been steadfast on the path. The angels descend upon them, telling them, you have no fear, no reason to be fearful or sorrowful. No fear, no sadness, no reason to be fearful or sad, not at all. And we are giving you glad tidings. Before they die, they are being given glad tidings at the point of death, that you will be entering paradise, subhanallah. You will be entering paradise completely. Abshiru, meaning we are giving you good news, bil jannah, of paradise. Allati kuntum tu'adun, that which you have been promised. Here you are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us in such a way that we die with a smile. And may He make the pangs of death very easy for us. And may He let the best of our deeds be the last of our deeds, so that we can go in His obedience. And may He let us pass away in a condition that He is absolutely pleased with us. Ameen. We also need to add, may He grant us the shahada on our tongues as we go. Ameen. So the angels come down saying, heaven is for you, Jannah is for you. أَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ Then Allah says, نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ You who have been steadfast, we want to tell you, we are your protectors in this world and in the Akhirah. We will protect you here and there. We will ensure that you are in order. Why? You ensured that whatever we said was in order. Allahu Akbar. You ensure that what Allah has said is in place. Allah says, we will ensure that when you need it most, we are always there. The Quran says this. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ In this world as well as in the next, we are your protectors. And Allah says, for you in paradise is whatever you wish for, whatever you desire is yours. Just desire it and it's yours. What a great and blessed place. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us paradise.